Wednesday hump day. It is part two of this game control. We're in it to hopefully win it. Now we gotta go to the damn red room. You know, this can't be good.
What is it? You can't let this happen. 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 You can't let this happen.
Y'all's Wednesday. Hopefully yesterday you had a good time. Hope you didn't miss me too much. So we're in part two. Not so bad. A little bit confused about what it is going on. But, I mean, that's me and most fucking video games, to be honest. So I'm gonna look at you.
Secure line of communication. Guide us. Breach the hotline.
The hotline, says the dead man. Okay.
Okay. Well, this is nothing to dead people, I guess. This is our life. I'll go get all this paperwork because I'm pretty sure that's going to be important. Oh my gosh, so I got this little body shaper things. This is normal. But anyway, I got body shaper thing and I used it for the first time. Man, that thing really makes me sweat. I don't know if that's the purpose of it. Who is talking? So yeah, it just, I went, I put it on, I was like, I'm gonna walk my daughter to school. Put it on, I went, walked my daughter to school. Went to the store, and then walked back home. And I took it off, it was like, like this wetness. Gross. I was like, oh, definitely need to take a shower. Okay.
The hissing sound that tried to invade me earlier. The hiss burrowing into everything in this place. Is the hiss your enemy? All right, it's our enemy. That babble's contagious. It burrows in like an infuriating melody that makes you hum it over and over. Cleanse the control point. What does that mean?
Yeah,
let me fix it.
Sane? to me. We saw you deal with the compromised agents.
It says, speak to someone. I'm not speaking to
you. I can't tell you how happy I am to talk to somebody sane.
How do you know that person's sane?
Yeah, I'm Pope, Emily Pope, Dr. Darling's assistant.
My turn. Should I lie?
Jesse Faden. I'm just visiting.
I should have lied.
Oh, shit. You're the new director. Hold on. We're coming out.
I should have lied. I'm probably gonna kill you now.
Director Faden. Call me Jesse. Okay, Jesse.
Jesse's got a gun. Wait, that's Jamie.
Look, somehow, this hostile force, this
hiss?
That works? Somehow the hiss managed to infiltrate the building without any warning.
And just like that, my name for it is official. The hiss. Like the sound of poison gas leaking in.
We're in full lockdown. It seems to have spread everywhere and to everyone not protected by an HRA. And, extraordinarily, you. You are the director, and that makes you special by definition. Trench is no longer the director, obviously. I'm sorry, I'm talking too much. This whole situation is just a lot.
She's babbling.
Trench is dead. Shot. Ah. I found his body. And the gun.
Do I tell her it looked like a suicide?
The service weapon. Also, and this can sound crazy, but he keeps appearing to me, saying things.
Why would you tell them that?
It's hard to make out, but he told me to cleanse the control point, push the hiss out. The whole room shifted around. You did that? And you entered the building when it was already in the lockdown, before you became the new director? How?
I'm not ready to tell her about you yet.
A janitor let me in. I love it. This is fucking unbelievable. It's... I can't even... look, Jesse, I have a million questions, and you probably have a million more.
Like, do you know my brother Dylan? Not yet.
But there's something I need to ask you to do first. If you can cleanse a control point, then you can maybe cure those infected or possessed by the hiss. Because if that's possible, our options are very different.
Emily Pope. I don't know her, but I like her already.
I don't.
She's the opposite of the faceless agency I've blamed for what happened to me for so long. But I can't trust her yet. Or rather, the Bureau she's a part of.
Yes. I can try.
I'm
speaking
head
for you, of course.
Why do I have to do this shit?
We can try it together.
I guess we could.
Okay. You with me? We did it before. Push the hiss out.
My fart? Anything in here of value? up, Emily. Really? Just gonna walk away from you? Cool. Let's go upstairs. I feel like fucking Randy Orton, I keep hearing voices in my head. A thing. We did a thing, y'all. I don't know what that was for, but okay, I pushed it. Magical or something, like, I'm so confused. dead end. There's things like this.
Ripping it out rips them apart.
Jesse, over here. We need to make a plan, Jesse. I can't
close
that. I wish I
had Jesse's girl.
Not really, she's crazy.
It was worth a shot. Thank you, Director. Jesse.
I'm gonna tell her why I'm here. I'll risk it.
Listen.
Risk that biscuit.
The Bureau was involved in an incident in my hometown, Ordinary, 17 years ago. The Bureau came in and covered the whole thing up. I've been looking for this place for a long time.
That's enough. Maybe that's too much already. I can't tell her about Dylan and the rest yet.
I've seen mentions of an altered world event case dealing with Ordinary. You were at Ground Zero as a child? It was one of the big ones, and before my time. And very classified. I can try to dig out some old files for you. My boss, Casper Darling, would know, but he's missing. I think he knew this was coming, or suspected. He came up with the HRAs, the Hadron Resonance Amplifiers. I think they're what saved us, or a few of us. And Director Trench would know.
Trench, the ghost, or whatever he is, he mentioned something called the hotline. Said I should find it.
It's another object of power, like the gun, an old Bakelite telephone. A direct line of communication between the director and the board. Maybe he can talk to you more clearly through that. I mean, Trench has years and years of experience. He might know how to destroy the hiss.
Where is the hotline?
It's kept in the communications department through the mailroom. It's part of this sector, so we can access it even with the lockdown in place. We'll get the door open for you.
Some bullshit.
Okay, that's my next stop.
That's Tomasi's department. He's head of communications. I don't think he had an HRA. He kind of made a point about not wearing one earlier. Keep an eye out.
They call me the director. But that's not me. I'm not a director type. I'm a leader.
Excuse me.
Why am I here? I think you already know.
No.
Yes, I came for my brother, but there are other reasons, too. I said I was looking for answers, but I might never understand them. I'm not looking for proof. This is already it. More than enough. No matter what they told me all those years, I know it's real now. I didn't imagine this. I want to be a part of this world. What scares me shitless is that I finally found it. Only to see the hiss destroy it all.
So, don't hesitate to ask me anything you want to know. There are no stupid questions. The door to the comms department is just outside the boardroom back in the lobby. They should have gotten it open by now. Follow the signs to the mailroom. You can get to the hotline containment chamber through there. Good luck, Jesse. See you back here once you have the hotline.
Thanks, Emily.
Let's all go to the lobby. Take that.
There it is again. Our welcome message.
Thank you.
Toya, why didn't you start the bathroom?
I don't know. Why not?
I think I'm going to stop it here at Dead Letters. This game is getting a little bit too intense for me. I don't know. But anyways, I hope you guys are enjoying this. Hope you guys are having fun. Hope you guys have a good day, evening, morning, whatever it is that you're watching this. And then after the fact, I hope you give it a like and subscribe and, you know, share it. I guess we'll see you guys tomorrow, right? You know how it goes. All right, bye.